Good evening, and thank you for checking us out here on the web, WMUR.com, or on the weather app. I'm meteorologist Haley LaPointe. Man, today was steamy. Take a look at these temperatures getting into the low and even mid-90s in many communities across the state. Nashua, 93. Auburn and Manchester also getting to 93. 91 degrees in Rochester. Lebanon hit 90. And along with this heat, we do have the humidity starting to creep up, too. It's becoming more noticeable. In Concord, we hit 92 degrees earlier today, so that makes 4 days total we've had this year where we've hit 90 degrees or gone above it. The other 3 days, by the way, happened in May. We average about 9 days per year where we'll hit 90. Last year, we only had three, so we're doing one better so far this year. The dew points have steadily been going up. Look at Plymouth, 67 degrees, 61 degrees. When you have dew points that are running in the 60s like that, it becomes almost oppressive, certainly uncomfortable. And by tomorrow, Tuesday and Wednesday, we'll have dew points running in the upper 60s, low 70s. We'll have that haze in the air. The air will feel thick and soupy. That's what we've got to contend with over the next couple of days. At least the heat won't be quite as heavy duty as what we saw yesterday and today on our Sunday. Not much happening on radar. We have been on the lookout for a couple of scattered showers or thunderstorms, but it was a very small chance today that we would see any of that. You can see a couple of spotty ones right along the coastline in Maine, but nothing has been spotted across our state. Up to the north in Quebec, where the showers and the storms have been, you can see them right by Ottawa. Eventually, this boundary is going to sink down toward the south, and that will trigger some storms and showers, but most of them will come in during the early part of the week. So our Sunday night shouldn't be any issues. We'll just have a few passing clouds from time to time. Then watch. Here we are at Monday morning. This is 8 a.m. A few clouds passing through, but really tomorrow is going to be not a bad day. We'll have hazy sunshine. And then watch once we get into the afternoon here. A few scattered thunderstorms and showers begin to develop. It looks like the greatest risk area tomorrow will be from the Monadnock region into the Upper Valley and then northern New Hampshire. But I got to tell you, as will be true with Tuesday and Wednesday's forecast, these are highly scattered, isolated storms. So some of you may get one Monday, then not get one Tuesday, Wednesday. Some of you may not get one Monday, but you might get one Tuesday. Or the town right down the street could get one Tuesday and you get nothing. So these are going to be very scattered. It's hard to pinpoint an exact time frame and a day. But at some point, probably within the next 3 days, you do run the risk of some scattered showers and thunderstorms. You can see Tuesday, we'll begin the day with a few clouds, probably some sunny breaks, and then in the afternoon again, we develop some of these scattered showers and thunderstorms. Some of the thunderstorms could contain the heavy downpours of rain and the gusty winds, too. At least they'll kick out the heat and the humidity, though. Overnight tonight, temperatures mainly in the 60s in Manchester, only in the upper 60s. It's another tough sleeping night. Might be tossing and turning if you don't have the AC, or even if you do, or a fan. Sometimes you get cold in the middle of the night, and it's just unsettled and restless. Tomorrow, 86 Concord in Manchester, a little bit cooler by the seacoast due to the winds coming off of the 63-degree Atlantic Ocean. So it will be slightly cooler there than it was today, 90 degrees in Portsmouth today. As we look ahead to the work week, again, scattered showers basically every day through midweek. And then temperatures will slowly start to decline. Look at that, 79 on Thursday. That will feel so good, especially since the humidity will be flushed out of the air at that time. Mostly sunny Thursday, Friday. Then next weekend, a few storms possible Saturday, then cranking up the heat again for the second half of the weekend.